Regular portals have two parts, blue and orange. They both act as input and output. But what about portals with three parts? Should that duplicate matter? Or should one part do time travel? Not really. I have an elegant geometric solution, but to understand it, we need to understand prerequisites first. In this video, I present you not only a portal with three parts, but also a portal with only one part. Afterwards, we'll merge them into an even stranger portal and explore other strange one-part portals. I discovered all of this myself. This is the Aptazorox channel, my name is Ilya, let's get started. As we learned in my previous video, a portal is made from a doorway. But now, nothing prevents us from creating a three-dimensional doorway. Then we can make a three-dimensional portal out of it. Any object still freely teleports, and you can even look through it from the side. This happens because light ray teleports twice and returns to the original place. The only thing is that the parts are now not symmetrical. But this isn't truly three-dimensional, so I call these surface portals. A true three-dimensional portal is a wormhole, like you may have seen in the movie Interstellar, and it's based on the warp of space, as shown in this picture. Okay, let's look at this scene. These look like normal portals, right? Actually no, if you turn off the light teleportation, they are hemisphere portals, but you can't really tell that by eye. This happens because the light ray teleported twice and returned to its original place, as we saw previously with the surface portals. So, the most important thing about portals is their frame, not their surface, as the surface doesn't actually affect anything. But for certain definition of portals it can affect something, but this is the topic for another video. If you want to dive deeper into this, read the description of this scene about non-linear movement. I know that there exists the Portal Reloaded game with three portals, which can do time travel. But it is possible to solve the question without such concept. If you haven't figured out the solution at this point, you can press pause and think if you want. A long time ago, I asked this question to my friend Artem Yashin, and he came up with a very interesting option that I had not thought of before. It uses double-sided portals and looks like this. To assemble it, we need three doorways, then just move their halves clockwise. So each piece depends on the previous one, and they are all connected. It's technically correct, but it is not what we are looking for. Now, let me tell you how I arrived at the answer. You know how they say that some discoveries are made by accident. That's exactly how I discovered the triple portal. It was about 3 am. I took the surface portal and thought, it's bent, but it preserves the incoming object, doesn't destroy it. What if this portal cut the incoming object? Then we don't want to think of it as a portal. We want portals to have the property of not destroying the incoming object. Otherwise, why do we need such a portal if we die using it? So that's a fundamental property of the portals we want. And what if we put some portal connections at the fracture points to keep the object from being cut? We'll call these support portals. It already looks like it's a three-part portal. At that time, I drew it all on a piece of paper and couldn't visualize the picture in my head, and I really wanted to see what it looks like. I didn't have a visual editor, and I was writing in C++. I wrote the matrices of all parts of the portal by hand, I compiled the code, ran it, and… At that moment, I felt something like this. Yes, it turned out to be a portal with three symmetrical parts, the real answer to the question. I didn't believe it would work until I programmed it and saw this with my own eyes. If you go through it, nothing will happen to you, you will be unharmed. You will be made up of several parts, but portals will provide cohesion to those parts. This portal can connect three universes. From the red universe, you can get to any of the other universes, green and blue. Such a portal can be assembled from a triple doorway or from three pairs of regular doorways, as you like. And now for the beauty. Normal portals, positioned opposite each other, give a repetitive and boring picture, even if you rotate them. But the triple portal is not like that. I've got a nice slider here that allows you to move all three portals symmetrically. Let's pull them back and spin them around. This makes these interesting rooms, and you can try so many positions, as you can see in these pictures. Picture 1, picture 2, picture 3. Interestingly, no one had invented the triple portal before me, even though it seemed like such a simple thing. By the way, the triple portal case can actually be generalized, and you can create portals that link as many worlds as you want. Take a look at this weird doorway. You can build 4 portals from it. After the surface portal, we can no longer say our portals are flat. So, how do you distinguish them from wormholes? I believe that, unlike wormholes, normal portals perform linear transformations over space, incoming objects and light. It means that straight lines remain straight, and parallel lines remain locally parallel. A wormhole definitely makes the light path not straight and distorts parallel lines. Moving and rotating are fairly obvious examples of linear transformations. So here's a non-obvious one. A mirrored doorway. Once you enter it, the whole world is mirrored for you. The next linear transformation is scaling. With the help of such a portal, you can shrink or enlarge objects. By the way, such portals were often used in the game Superliminal. And the last linear transformation is called skew or shear. I don't know what it's good for, but I just want you to know about it. Now about a portal with only one part. Can you guess it? Here's a clue. You have 2 of them at your home. And there are 4 of these elementary ones. You can pause to think about it. And the answer is this. The first simple one-part portal is a doorway. Okay, the second one is a regular mirror. Yes, a mirror is also a portal, it's just that you can't enter it, because you are interfering with yourself. Now, what happens if you mix their properties? You get the mirrored doorway we already seen, and the mirror without mirroring. That's the answer to the question about one-part portal. I call it a monoportal. You see the text on the wall. Now you look into the portal, and it's not mirrored. You can go into it and you come out the other side. What's interesting is that the only mention of this kind of portal I found is in this 12-year-old video. And it's not magic, it's made up of ordinary portals. Can you guess how? And here's the answer. Take a doorway, shaped like a semi-ellipse. Unfold one portal. Merge them. And then remove the borders. And that's basically it. Here are 2 bare parts of one portal. You are probably wondering why they don't tear both object and space. Why is it considered a valid portal? The first sign is that the picture across this boundary maintains continuity. And next, this boundary can't tear the object, because it will interfere with itself. An interesting property is that such a portal does not change the picture in any way if you rotate it around the vertical axis. By the way, a mirror without mirroring can be assembled from 2 regular mirrors. This is called a true mirror. You can watch a video from Action Lab about it. This is a rotating monoportal. While our last monoportal gave symmetry around the axis parallel to the portal plane, this one creates symmetry perpendicular to the portal plane. That is, it simply rotates the object next to it by 180 degrees. That's why it is called rotating. To assemble this portal, you'll have to rotate half of a regular monoportal in the fourth dimension to reflect it. Or you can assemble it initially from a round mirrored doorway. What happens if you cross a monoportal and a triple portal? Does that sound like nonsense? Well, let's see. You get a triple monoportal. It's a regular monoportal, but between its halves is not 180 degrees, but 120 degrees, which makes it look like there are 3 parts. And it doesn't tear anywhere because of this arrangement. The object next to it looks like it has 3 copies. In fact, you can do it this way for any number of sub-portals, 4, 5 and so on. Or you could summon Satan. Whereas the other monoportals could reflect, rotate and who knows what else, this portal can do another basic transformation, just offset. Let's see how it is formed. It takes a regular monoportal, and one part of it is shifted upwards. Then support portals are used to eliminate the places where space is broken and to connect everything together. In the end, we get a portal that shifts everything to half its height. By the way, I have a slider that allows you to change the amount of displacement, and you can see that nothing but 0 and half height position work, because the picture breaks. Remember the scaling portal. Can we make a scaling monoportal? Then it would need to have a single surface that somehow scales up and down simultaneously. Seems like an impossible task, especially considering that our portals are made up of discrete parts, and there would have to be some sort of gradual scaling to fit everything into one surface. It doesn't look like a linear transformation. Let's take the offsetting monoportal and transform its shape into a trapezoid, and then shrink that trapezoid so that the portals match. That's a scaling monoportal. You can easily change the degree of scaling from none to infinitely small. If you enter the upper part, your size will increase, and if you enter the lower part, your size will decrease. You can even see it in the way the scale of the supporting portals has changed. But there is another solution to this problem. Take a rotating square monoportal with a hole. Add a doorway at the bottom, which will then become a supporting portal. Then we reduce one part, keeping relative dimensions. In this portal, the left side is larger than the right side. This is how the change of the scale is ensured, and the continuity of the surface is provided by the supporting portal. If we want to go into the left part, we will be decreased in size, which can be seen from the right part. And with the right part, it works vice versa, we can come out enlarged. So here the problem is solved using clever design and supporting portals. Also, this option can be turned into a logarithmic spiral that increases and decreases in radius exponentially. From this position you can see through the supporting portal that the large part continues perfectly along the current part. Similarly with the small part. Many people have probably thought of the following set of portals. We take two pairs of portals and arrange them in a square. This creates an infinite portal room. It's almost like a mirror room. If we paint the walls of different portals with different colors, we get this picture. This portal can be assembled in an alternative way, and then we'll get a different picture in the portal room. By the way, exactly the same room can be assembled from hexagons. Ideologically, it is no different from a square room. And there is an alternative position which also alternates colors. It's called a tiling, and I have shown you two regular tilings. Do you think it is possible to create a portal in the form of a triangular tiling? Actually, yes, and that's what it looks like. And it's pretty simple to assemble. Take the monoportal and bend it into a triangle. It turns out that all three of these portals are also sort of monoportals, because they have one part and one continuous teleporting surface. But what about semi-regular tilings? Take this handsome fellow for example. I figured out that only three parts are enough. Two triangular and one square. In this picture you can see a scheme of how to assemble it from regular pairs of portals. This is how it looks with light teleportation. First you can see that the floor is light and the ceiling is dark. You can see that some of the portals have a picture of the dark ceiling, simply because they are upside down. And if you look inside, you get this set of rooms. Like any triple portals, they can all be arranged into all sorts of interesting fractal pictures. But I won't focus on that. Of course, in exactly the same way, other tilings can be made. As always, you can try out every scene that I showed here in my web demo. That's all that I have for you in this video, but I am already making another video on portals, so subscribe if you don't want to miss it. Thanks for watching, bye!